Hello everyone, and welcome to this tutorial on how to do my double camcorder setup that I'm going to be using to record video games directly in the future, you know, like a capture card, but with a camcorder. The first thing you're going to need is, of course, a camcorder, but not just any camcorder. A camcorder that has this thing right here. I don't know if you can see it here. It says AV in. You absolutely have to have a camcorder that has AV in. Oh, there we go. It just wasn't focusing on it correctly, but yeah. The one that I'm using right here is an Apetek A-HD Plus 1080p camcorder, and you, of course, need the cord that comes with it to plug into that AV input on that camcorder, which should come with the camcorder if you buy it new. It looks like one of these things here. It's got the red, white, and yellow connectors with a headphone-like jack on top of that, on the other side, I should say. Next thing you need is one of these things here. It is a female-to-female coupler. They actually sent me the wrong one here. This one's by GT Max. I wanted a red, white, and yellow one, but they gave me a blue, green, and red one, which is for component, but I wanted a one for composite. But colors don't matter when it comes to this, so really you don't even need to have any colors on this whatsoever. This is just to help you match your things up. I'll make it easier for you to follow, but you just need one of these things. Female to female RCA coupler like that, or AV coupler, whatever you want to call it. The next thing you need is three of these. I got these from Pyramid. They are RCA Y connectors. They look like this. Two male ends and one female end. Please focus for me, thank you. Well, you're kind of focusing, well, whatever. So, you plug something in this end, and it gets split over to these ends. Yeah, this is a signal splitter of sorts, and you need three of these. One for each of the colors on the RCA connectors. And then you need you don't have to have sand disks. You just need a SD card for the camcorder. Since I'm using two camcorders, one to record my voice, one for the game system, I needed two SD cards. I would recommend, probably 4 GB for a card at the least. I got 8 GB. Fours can be bought for about $10. Eights can be bought for about $20. And another camcorder for your voice. This one doesn't really matter, but you'd probably prefer to have good quality. You know, for your voice, but this one that I got is a Polaroid DVG 1080p. And finally, and of course, you need a game system. This is connected up at towards the Wii there. I don't feel like getting it out of that little alcove there, because I have to pull the cords and stuff like that out of there. But so I'm just going to be using these cords here. Yeah, it's the AV cords coming straight from the system. Alright, let's get this tutorial started. I kind of forgot to mention the prices. This can be bought for about $50 to $80, depending on where you buy it from. You just gotta shop around. The coupler, that the GT Max coupler here, was about $3. The Pyramid Y connectors that I had here were 99 cents a piece. Finally, the Polaroid DVG 1080p camcorder was about $70. You could probably find it cheaper, too. Alright, the first thing that I'm going to be doing is making things a lot less complicated for you. Like, you remember that I said that the colors don't matter? Well, see this cord? I am going to make it a lot easier for you to follow. Just watch. Whoa, and like magic, they have tape on them. Yeah, I made some colored tape here. We didn't have any actual color tape, so I Sharpie markered over some paper tape. But basically, each of these splitter cables are going to be one kind of signal. So one's going to be red, one's going to be white, one's going to be yellow. The same goes for this thing. I put tape over it as well, so you'll be able to follow it easier. Alright, so how do I get the signal from the game system here into that camcorder, as well as the TV up there? That is the puzzle, and I'm going to show you how to do it. Okay, so you have your splitter cables here. You can see the colors. Match those colors right up. As I said, the color on the cord doesn't matter whatsoever. I'm just making this tutorial a little easier for you by adding tape to the things. And now what you have here is a split signal of the game system going off into three different directions. Well, two different directions, but it's three different chords, and then those chords are getting split off like so. Alright, the next thing you want to do is try and get this signal into the camcorder. And on the camcorder, you'll see a little latch. Usually there's, well, some sort of cover of some sort. And well, I don't know what to call it. Like a rubber protector thing. And then you'll see something like this, AV in and out. Plug in that cord that comes with the camera into the AV in and out. And there you go. And so then you get to this end of the cord right here. And you're like, man, how do I fit this together with these? They're male on male. Well, that's why you have the coupler. So take one end of the coupler, well, not the coupler, excuse me, one end of the splitter cables and put them into the coupler, and then you're going to connect the camera into the coupler on the other side, like this. So you've got, like, that, and the camcorder goes like this. Done! And what you want to do is open up your camcorder like this and check it out. You should be getting an AV in signal. You can probably see that on the camcorder. Select that like so, unless it does it automatically, and there is the game system. Oh, it's in sleep mode. Hold on, I gotta turn on the Wii remote. There we go. Now it's just focus for me properly. Yeah, I guess you can see it. But yeah, there is the Wii screen. But the screen is, of course, far, far too small to play games on. Plus, it has a delay. So I want to put the game signal also up towards the TV. And that's what the other side of the splitter cables are for. So, take your other end of your splitter cables and just plug them into the appropriate colors on your TV. And, here we go. Boink! There is the game system. It's not, it's both in the camcorder and it's both on the TV, excuse me. You get the idea. So, now all you have to do is just start recording on the camcorder and you're good to go. For your voice, you just use the second camcorder, which is what I'm using right now for this tutorial that I'm talking into. Or I should say talking behind. And yeah, that's really about it. It's pretty simple. It's kind of inexpensive, but you do have to put a little bit into it, of course. So if you're not thinking about doing walkthroughs like often or doing game videos often, this setup probably isn't for you. But if you do want to get more professional with your videos and aren't planning on quitting anytime soon like I am, this is definitely a good setup for you. It's portable, it's easy to do, and as I said, quite inexpensive. Well, at least compared to buying a capture card and a computer to go along with it to be portable. Unless you play your game system like right next to your TV, then a capture card would probably be cheaper. But even so, capture cards are kind of iffy with consistency. Like, they can corrupt the audio or video randomly because your computer might want to do a process or something like that, and then it'll mess it up. Well, and then you're going to lose your footage, and that would really suck. But I'm rambling here. That was the tutorial. I hope you enjoyed, and I hope it was helpful. I'll see you later.